And the New York Times reports your body may not thank you for taking a break from exercise. There are two new studies from the University of Liverpool and McMaster University, among others, and they monitored active people who abruptly started sitting more. Now, this caused their blood sugar levels to rise, insulin sensitivity to decrease, and weight to increase. The study's volunteers returned to an active lifestyle after 2 weeks, but the undesirable metabolic changes did not fully reverse. Our Dr. David Agus is here this morning. You might have seen him dancing in the green room.
We noticed.
I know.
Although I still can't get the image of Anthony in that massage chair out of my head.
I can't get it out either because it's just so enticing. Yeah,
soothing.
So this is kind of, does age factor into whether you can bounce back after you have an exercise break? Because I feel like we all have a period like that where you end up taking a break because of work or illness or something.
No question about it. So in older studies, it had shown that college kids who were done in, they would sit and go from 10,000 steps a day to 1,000 steps a day, and you saw all these changes happen in the body. Insulin insensitivity, metabolic changes, and then they started to go back to exercising. Within 2-3 days, they were back to where they were. Mm-hmm. But in this study, over the age of 65, they didn't. After 2 weeks, most of them hadn't changed at all. Mm-hmm. They were still back to that change that happens with being sedentary. So age does matter.
So meaning as you get older, it's more important to make sure you exercise every day or every other day.
Well, everybody should. But yes, especially as you get older, taking that 2-week break has real ramifications, not just for those 2 weeks, but for many, many weeks afterwards.
But less than a quarter of us are getting the exercise we should.
As we all sit down and say this to each other, we're not moving enough.
Yeah.
What is the right kind of exercise when we talk about going back to the gym?
Well, our bodies were designed to move. So movement is key. It changes our muscles. You know, our lymphatics that control our immune system have no muscle in the walls, which is the rhythmic contraction of the muscles in your legs when you walk that make your body work. So it's movement over time. 5 to 10 minutes every hour. Mm-hmm. Try to do 10 to 15 minutes a day where your heart rate gets 50% higher from where it starts. And that's kind of the minimum. But really do it every day. Movement over time is critical.
We're not talking necessarily about intense exercise here. We're talking about movement?
Yeah, movement over time. I mean, walking makes you live longer. As simple as that.
Yeah.
Our bodies, when somebody upstairs designed and engineered our bodies, it required movement. So our muscles working actually makes our body work. And so those couple of weeks of being sedentary, when the sugar goes up, that changes your blood vessels, raises your risk of heart disease, stroke, blood pressure, and all those other things. So the key is, you know, this life is a marathon. And so every day you need to build something into it. No. So really the take home is movement over time. The take home is 10 to 15 minutes a day, get your heart rate up. And the take home is make yourself uncomfortable. Sometimes do things that you're not used to doing.
Climb
exercise
the stairs.
Wise. Yeah. Climb the stairs. You do yoga. I don't like it, but it works.
My girlfriends are in town from San Antonio, Texas. We went and worked out yesterday for 90 minutes. And my trainer, Kira Stokes, she says, be grateful that you have the ability to move. And
that's true.
So inspiring to sort of hear that and reminds you you should do it every day. But again, kind of to that question that Alex was asking, how about the intensity level? Is it okay just to walk with a friend, or do you have to run, lift weights, resistance, all that stuff?
I love that. As Norah gets her fist, she's like, what about that intensity level?
Boxing.
What we know now.
We learned boxing is good for preventing Parkinson's.
That's right. Yeah.
It is. Yeah. Yes, intensity is key. And so, even as you get older, 60s and 70s, you do a brief, intense workout, there are clear benefits to it. And so our bodies were kind of designed to move during the day, but that intensity helps both cardiovascular and brain-wise. You know, sitting, they showed in a UCLA study, thins the part of the brain involved in memory.
Okay.
So you want to remember names of people and all? Exercise and get out there.
All right.
So we'll be doing the show standing the rest of the way.
Exactly.
Dr. David Agus, thank you
Doing the shiggy and standing.